And the main thing is that our bodies really do need periods of what we call fasting. And I don't like that word because it sounds like we're denying ourselves something. Really, it's restricting the hours that we actually do feed is a better way to think about it. And the hours that we are actually feeding, the sugars that are easily released during that are meant to help our cells grow, to be plastic in terms of the way that they function within an organ, to help regenerate cells. So we do need food, but equally important, we need times where our bodies do not have food stuffs to process. And during after about 8 hours of not having food intake, the body has this wonderful mechanism to start to extract calories and nutrients from the fat stores. And viewers of this channel know about ketosis. And ketosis is important for lots of reasons. Number one of which is it's telling you that you actually are burning fat. And if you're trying to lose weight, at some point you've got to be able to burn fat. But the other thing about ketosis is the ketone bodies that are produced that are fuel. Yes, they are fuel for the cells during times when we're not eating. But more importantly, they are signals for lots of pathways within the cell to repair DNA, to make new mitochondria, which are the power plants in the cell, to reprocess the organelles, the little tiny structures in a cell that make it work, to repair them and to replace them so that they're healthy, to control the impact of hormones on the cell. So a whole host of processes that are damaging to the cell are actually undone while we're not eating. And so to have 12 to 16 hours of no new food intake, water is fine, no calories is what we mean, allows your body to create ketone bodies that do these wonderful metabolic switching and signaling that actually promotes health and health span and longevity as well. So that was the most powerful thing for me in that article was the essential value for ketone bodies.
The Louisville event was an incredible success. Many people didn't know that that was our first attempt to coordinate the whole thing ourselves. And it was better than we had hoped. A lot of focus and people saying, you know what, I know that we can deal with this together as a group. There are other people that I'm meeting here at this event that are doing the same things I'm doing and with success. I don't have to be a doctor to know all this stuff. We are going to go ahead and have another one on February 28th in the Hyatt Regency Grand Cypress in Orlando.